Hello everyone, welcome to another video. Today I'd like to talk to you a little bit about conforming your project to a new video edit or timecode change. Now this is extremely useful whenever you have a situation where the video editor cut the film or the video to a shorter length and you have to resync the entire project to match that edit. That can be very stressful because it's gonna consume a lot of time, of course. But fortunately, there is a way that you can just copy and paste sections of your project to match to the new timecode change. And hopefully this video is going to clear that out for you. But anyways, let's get into it. So what I've got here on Pages is my little EDL that I adapted to this project. So you can see that right here I have the final cut edit. So for example, the start time goes from 1 hour to 1 hour, 20 seconds and 9 frames. And then for the other scenes right here, where the time code, the original one, would be from this one to this one, I cut it down from this time code to this one. So instead of starting at 1 hour, 23 seconds and 4 frames, it will now start at exactly 1 hour, 20 seconds and 9 frames, which is the exact ending of the start time. So this is a reference for me to know which scenes were cut to what time. And then when I come down here to the Pro Tools section, I'm gonna start the edit at 2 hours and just reconform from 2 hours to 1 hour. But before this gets too confusing, let me just show you what I mean. So coming here to Final Cut, what I'm gonna do is duplicate the video upwards and mute the bottom one. Then coming here to Pages again, I'm gonna copy the end time of the start of the video and paste it to the timecode right here. And then I'm going to split it and then come here and copy the start time from the running scene. Paste it right there. And then put a marker here, copy the end time as well. Then hit a marker. Then I'm going to cut it right here and then right there and just delete this one. So now I know that the start time of this specific scene is gonna come all the way down here to 20 seconds and 9 frames, which is respective to this section right here. And then when I just move it, you'll also see that the end time, which is 34 seconds and 27 frames, matches the end time of the new edit. So I'm gonna do this for all of the clips and I'll meet you in a second. Okay, so the edit is now done and I've already got a video exported, so I'm just gonna go back to Pro Tools and get that video from here. So you can see that it's all trimmed and good to go. And then when I turn that on and mute the full video, you'll see that everything sounds wrong. So I'm just gonna play back from the beginning. So as you can see, everything is now completely out of sync, and to try to resync all of that manually would take a lot of time and would only stress you out. So to avoid this problem, let's just lower the video right here and reload the full video track. And let me just make sure that the beginning of this file matches the beginning of the video. And also let me just make sure that there isn't any sound happening in this frame. All right, cool, so it's all good. And what I'm gonna do is select the full video and select all of these tracks and then just extend the time here a little bit. Then I'm gonna group it with Option Command G. And now selecting the markers as well, so Shift click, I'm gonna hit copy and then move to 2 hours and paste it. So now I've got my entire project at 2 hours. And remember that the timecode that I put here for the Pro Tools conform starts at 2 hours, and now you're gonna see why. So coming back here, I'm gonna delete the entire project from 1 hour and the markers as well. and hide the full video track. And then coming back here to the 2-hour mark, I'm going to start making those selections. So I'm just going to close the video so everything gets easier and put the Pro Tools session right here and the EDL right there. So now I'm just going to rearrange this view. So you hit Command and move it right here just so it gets easier to visualize that. So now coming from the start of this group, I'm going to hit slash to select the start time right here, then type 2 hours, which is already there, which is fine, and then hit slash again to go to the end time and select 2 hours, 00:20:09, hit enter, and you're going to see a selection there. So I'm just going to select the entire group as well and the markers lane right here, hit copy, and then hit asterisk to go to 1 hour again, and then paste it. And now let's do the same thing with all of the other scenes right here. So without going back to 2 hours, because I've already got the selection right here, I'm just going to hit again slash to go to the start time, and then go 2 hours, 00:23:04, and then slash again, and then 2 hours, 00:37:22, hit enter, copy, asterisk, and then 1 hour, 00:20:09. Hit enter, hit paste, and there you have it. And then again for the thunder scene, slash 02:00:38:11, slash 02:00:40:06. Enter, copy, and then asterisk 01:00:34:27. Enter, paste. And then for the punch scene, slash 02:00:43:00, slash 02:00:45:22. Enter, copy, asterisk 01:00:36:22. And then enter and paste. And finally for the end title scene, slash 02:00:49:23, slash 02:00:58:22, enter, copy, asterisk 01:00:39:14, enter and paste. And there you go. And now I'm just gonna ungroup everything and just extend the little end of my music track right there. And now let's have a listen to the final result. It's gonna sound a little bit funky, of course, because we just cut the sound to match the new picture, but everything is now gonna be in sync, and all that you need to do is just tweak the little edits. And of course, if you're composing the music, you're gonna have to readjust the music to match the new timing. But let's just get out of full screen and open the video, and it should be good now. That's perfectly in sync. And that's pretty much it for this video. I really hope that it was helpful to you. If you have any questions about it, please let me know down in the comments. And as always, I wish you have a great day, and I'll talk to you soon. See ya!